Good day, fellow investors. I really enjoyed Peter Thiel's book 0 to 1, which is a business book. But as Warren Buffett says, I'm a better investor because I'm a businessman, and the better businessman because I'm an investor. That's why we have to learn more about business. And I've really enjoyed both book. I made lots of annotation. I think Peter Thiel is a genius because geniuses can summarize so many concepts into one book. And for example, there is so much talk about business, about spawning, the spawning investment framework that we discussed when analyzed Pabrai's ideas when investing. So check that video out if you haven't. And I just want to give you a quick summary of the key business concepts discussed in the book, and then really urge you to read this. Let's start with the questions. Let's immediately go into that, and we'll also cover Palantir stock that is mentioned often in the book, and I have received so many concepts to discuss it. The first concept is the engineering question. Boom, immediately. Is the product 10 times, not 10%, 10 times better than the competition? If you have that kind of business, then, well, the rest is pretty much easy. But this is necessary to have no competition. You need to be 10 times better. Is this the right time to start a particular business? Think of all the space activities that are going on now. Maybe space travel will be okay 20 years from now. Maybe not now. Maybe it's too early. My father's internet business went bust because he was a year too early in 1994. Yes, I had an email in 1993 for the first time, but that's a different story. So it's always thinking, is it the right time? Because you might have everything right, but the timing might be wrong. Then we go to durable competitive advantages. How long is the runway? So a lot talking, Peter Thiel, Warren Buffett, businessmen, a lot of things that are common there. Durable competitive advantages, moats, always the same story. How can you build something and then protect it? The people question, of course, Elon Musk, Peter Thiel, all amazing managers, all great innovators and also executors. And the question is always, when it comes to business, it's all about people. And as Warren Buffett says, you should either have great management or a business that an idiot can run, because sooner or later an idiot will run it. Something very important for us investors, and also to put into a market cap perspective that we'll later also discuss with Palantir, is how long is the runway? And then as investors, we have to compare it to the market capitalization that's already there. Peter Thiel starts small with his investments, and the runway is, okay, $1 billion, $10 billion, $50 billion, $100 billion. But if we as an investor start at $50 billion, the runway is much smaller than if we would start at $5 billion. So that's also something to think from a business investing perspective. The durability question, how long can the business last before something else comes out? There is so much technology developments going on lately, and I'm pretty much very careful about investing there, because if you come into the market, disrupt everything, and you did that in just a few years, it means that anybody else can do the same in a few years. And that's something that really makes me worry about investing in these tech hot stocks that are trading at 50 times sales, because I don't know who will next come into the market with an even more disruptive technology. And this is really important. The secret question, specific reasons for success that other people don't see. When we invest, we all have the numbers. You just put a screen, Bloomberg, this, whatever, you get all the numbers you want, and we later also see with Palantir. But what's the secret that makes it different? That's something that you really need to dig deeper, understand the business, and that's something you really need to apply yourself to get there. That's what I do with my research platform, for example. I follow businesses, and it really takes time to really understand the DNA of the business and the environment it operates in. And now let's go to Palantir Stock. A lot of comments, and I've tried to look at what they do. I've looked at some YouTube videos from them, look at their website, and I must say, I didn't understand exactly what they do, which is the first step to not investing in that or not digging deeper. But I think I can give you one piece of value to give you a different perspective on Palantir. If we look at the stock, Palantir Technologies, so recent IPO, and did really well, not so exuberant over the last year, but still, initial investors did really, really okay. However, there is one thing I want to notify here that differentiates us from Peter Thiel. That's a 41.7 billion market capitalization. Peter Thiel founded the company, so he started at a market capitalization of zero, or the few millions they invested at day one. And you start still a great business, and Peter Thiel mentions it here a lot of times, and you or we started 40 billion. If you bought her here early, you started at 20 billion. Okay, but still, the runway is limited as the risks are increased for a business like Peter Thiel likes. Of course, if we look at Morningstar, they really like it because it's a hot stock. It's their business to analyze stocks. They give it a fair value of 25, that the business will create strong structures over the long term and then add value to shareholders. However, price to sales is 34.35. There is a price earnings ratio, so that's okay, but the growth should be staggering to justify 34.35 sales. If we look at key ratios, and they say to me that if you are not logged in or a member, this is unfortunately removed. So, okay, that was a lot of value, so logically they removed it. But the growth is, what is this, 25, 30%? That's not staggering growth. And according to this, they are still losing money, issuing shares, especially with the IPO. So that's also a way to make money for Peter Thiel. And something that I noticed in the book, Peter Thiel said in 2014-13 they had a billion of revenues. So that's something to check whether I read it correctly, because the revenues then were lower. So it's not just about growth, or it's not about the same business model. Something happened here, and that's something we have to check if you want to invest deeper. But 40 billion, 1.2 billion revenue, okay, really, really good gross margin. So if you can scale this and bring it to 12 billion, then you are already at 5-6 billion of profits, and then that's already something, even into the current market capitalization. But still, it's a long runway, especially from an investing perspective for the business. The risk is pretty high, the reward is already limited, and therefore this is not an investment I would look deeper into. Thanks for watching, smash that like button if you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one.